Welcome to Digital Asset News. To get top stories in cryptocurrency and digital assets and break them down to bite-sized pieces. So today, it is one of those days that is the usual for the cryptocurrency and digital asset market, where Bitcoin has taken a little bit of a correction of $10,000 over 24 hours. So the real question is, why did this happen? Was it because of a tweet from Elon Musk? Was it a massive outflow from F2 pool and mining pool base in China? Or was it because of the reopening of the Chinese markets? We're gonna take a look at all three scenarios and I'm gonna tell you why it really doesn't matter. And actually, this is great news for dollar cost averagers. On top of that, we'll take a look at the old school entrepreneur.com where they talked about JP Morgan said that Bitcoin would never go above 40,000 and we leave that in the dust. We'll also take a look at what is going on with crypto.com or their coin as it jumps up over 100% in less than 24 hours because of a token burn. And finally, the CEO of Ledger comes out and has a AMA, which is going to be scheduled for this Friday. And I've always said, it doesn't matter what happened as far as a scandal or a breach, it is all how you handle it. So we'll take a look at all that, but let's take a look at what's going on in the market right now, which is today. So we're looking at, today is February 22nd, 10 a.m. El Paso, Texas time. Not a bad day so far. I mean, as far as weather-wise, not so great for the market. And if you're new to the market and you've come over from the traditional space, welcome. Congratulations. What a great day to start on your journey of cryptocurrency. But just know that these days are common and it's not a big deal. And actually, if you look at it in the right way, when you take a look at these huge dips, you can just take a step back and go, you know what? These are great sales. When you go into any kind of store, any kind of it doesn't matter if it is a clothing store, electronics store, whatever else. When you see something 10% off, 20% off, what do you usually do? You usually want to buy it. It's amazing to me how people just look at these different types of things as far as the market goes and go, oh my God, it's 20%. I got to get rid of it. Instead of looking and going, wow, what a flash sale. I used to have that same mentality. It just as years has hardened me into this market, it just is like another great day to pick up some really cheap cryptocurrency and digital assets because I know where they're going. And they're not going south. They will always rebound. And what goes up must come down. But these are the days that you live for as far as a investor. So Bitcoin right now is at 53,000. It looks like it dropped 7%. Hey, not too bad. Ethereum dropped over 10% though. Wow, 1727. And we did a video yesterday and I talked about how I was concerned about the market. It was very difficult for me to sell. I'll link this at the very end. And I sold some of my Ethereum at $2,000. Now, does this make me Nostradamus and I can predict everything? No, I just got lucky. That's really what it comes down to. I'm just an investor. I'm not a trader. I do a little bit of trading, but it's like 5%, 3 to 5% of my portfolio. I don't like to trade that much. It just doesn't really work out for me. But it is fun, and I'm learning from the guys over there at Market Rebellion, also from Trade the Chain. So when I do these things, people, after that video, like, you're an idiot. You got to stop selling because it's only going to go to the moon. Well, here we are. So you just have to remember that just pick your price points and whatever your goals are, whatever you're comfortable with, because my goals are not your goals. Just take a look at the market as, just opportunities abound, and this is one of those days. Binance coin number 3, it had a massive run, but it's even that retraced 13%. Tether, nobody cares. Polkadot, still at $35, but it's down. Everything's down, let's just be honest, except for XRP. Congratulations, XRP. This is your day, right? Everything's down. You guys are up 6%. Congratulations, that's amazing. And then everything else is pretty much, just going down, down, down. But there is one. Crypto.com is up 60% in the 24-hour time frame. What's going on? Actually, is it 60%? Yeah, 24-hour time. And the last hour went down a little bit. But we're going to talk about why it is going up so much. And it totally makes sense. I don't really know why they did this huge burn, but we'll go over that in a bit. So it looks pretty good. Let's just do like the one-hour projected range. And so I would like to do this to see what could potentially goes up. LA token. No idea what that is, but apparently it could go up 26%. Or with 90% assurance, it's going to go up 6.85%. And this is from, Trade the Chain because they do all the different sentiment analysis. Utrust, Bitcoin Gold, I wouldn't touch that, but okay. Engine Coin, that's a good one. I used to actually have Engine Coin. Pretty good for NFTs and gameplay and stuff like that. Tomo Chain, BitTorrent. Ooh, my friend George is going to love this. 8% up potentially. So, and then Crypto.com. you never know where that's going to go. So that's what's going on this side. Let's just delve into what is really going on as far as the market. So this was just a screen capture I had over there at CoinGecko, and it just shows you the veracity, or just how amazing these things can dip. And we saw a pretty big dip right here, 58,307 down to 49,116. So not 10,000 exactly, but pretty darn close. Again, if you're in the market, just get used to this. 10% isn't a big deal. 20%, nah. 30%, all right, now we're talking. 40%, I'm listening. And then on and on you go. So this is not the traditional market space. Some people, in the traditional market, they're like, hey, we went up 10% or whatever. I'm like, that's a Tuesday for us. Who cares? So this is just a different space, and no need to worry about it, because it's volatile, and 10% swings, not a big deal. 20%, we'll probably see a retracement. We're already up back up to 53,000. So look, you just got to take it with a grain of salt. So what's going on? All right, so we'll talk about it. So Elon Musk said on a tweet, and he just talked about, I'm going to go this very quickly because it's kind of goofy. Elon Musk said, hey, there might be some old things, might be overvalued as far as the crypto market, but it is less, he said it's less dumb money than fiat. Like, oh, that makes sense. That's the whole story. So, okay, we got that one. And then the second one is, this was from, let me minimize this. Actually, let me blow this up so you can actually see it. I should have done this before. Yeah, this is from friends of the show, George over there at Cryptos R Us, who just hit 104,000 viewers. Congratulations, George over at Cryptos R Us. And he's always got this great data right here from CryptoQuant. And he talks about how there's this huge outflow, which you can see. I can't see my mouse, unfortunately, but it said 1.6 billion worth. And then he talks about how MicroStrategy should gobble that up for these institutions. However, when we take a look at this, we're like, that's a lot of Bitcoin for these miners to dump. And if you don't know F2 Pool, it's one of the five big mining pools there based in China. But remember, they're a mining pool. So all the different, people, different miners will connect to them, but they have a lot of their rigs right there, I suppose. And they just dumped a ton of Bitcoin on the market, which is kind of odd, especially with what we talked about this weekend, as far as like Michael Saylor said that a lot of these mining pools could just borrow against the Bitcoin that they have and put it on the debt market, and then have this debt for 1, 3, 5 years, and let it ride. But for some reason, whatever the reason is, F2 Pool's like, nope, we want to get rid of this, and they put a ton of it out in the open market. So when people talk to me and they're like, hey, we're not going to see big retracements or something like that. This isn't a big retracement. Just it's like 7%, 8%. But I still think that we're going to have a bear market at some point. Nothing goes up forever. And just so you know, like these types of things, if people are always saying, well, the institutions are here, never going to go anywhere, never going to sell. Sure. I've heard that song and dance before, and we'll see what happens. I mean, to me, it only makes sense that things will just continue to go up. It made sense to me in 2017, 2018, 2019, 2020. But you have to let the world catch up to you at some point, because a lot of people just don't get it. I mean, heck, even the Motley Fool, who are supposed to be these geniuses for finance, they just like a week ago said, hey, we're going to buy 5 million of Bitcoin at 50 grand. Good job. So, I mean, with all these things that are going on, you just kind of have to take it with a grain of salt and go, all right. I just don't think that that much mass amount of Bitcoin, they can't, there's only so much they can gobble up. And once new people come in, like more retail like us, we might get a little bit scared and start to sell. That's why you're watching this channel. So I'm trying to just alleviate some of those fears and say, this is normal, no big deal. Next day, here we come. All right, so we have that part. And then of course, there's another piece here. Somebody said, I just got a call from my Chinese friend. Looks like drop is due to reopening of the Chinese markets. Just a temporary sell-off, sure. So you take all those three things together and you go, well, maybe it's this, or maybe it's this, maybe it's this. But I'm going to ask you a question right now. Who cares? Who cares what it is? Does it really matter? Does it really matter, like, there was a reason for this or reason for that that they sold off? Who cares? All you got to do is just sit back and look at this and go, what does this mean to me? So if you've been in for like more than a month, this isn't a big deal. Because you're just like, okay, well, what happened is that it went down. I just told my, before I did this video, I I was telling my wife, I go, hey, just so you know, Bitcoin dumped a little bit and it's down 10,000, which means the entire market's down. So please make sure that you buy some crypto. Okay. She's like, okay. And then our big thing is we're not going to buy any more Bitcoin right now. We have our positions. But I told her, don't forget to buy Cardano. Don't forget to buy Voyager. Or if you want to do some Polkadot, that type of thing. I go, but just make sure you buy something today. Okay. And that's it. So as a investor, these are the time that you have to live for and just go, thanks for the gift. I really appreciate it. Now, if you're a trader and you just got wrecked because you're over leveraged and things like that, I can't help you on that one. But there's just more days. That's why I'm not a big trader. I mean, I know there's a lot of people on the channel that love trading. I just can't do it. Just a little crazy for me. I just think, you know, I'll just buy and hold. I'll hit my positions and then when I want to cash out, I cash out. So again, not a big deal. This is just one of those days. Anyhow, let me know what you think in the comment section and let's move on to our next piece, which really wasn't a next piece, just actually an add-on. I just want to remind you of all the naysayers out there, especially if you're new. What's the term? Haters gonna hate. Haters gonna hate, right? And this was from JP Morgan. If you've been here for a while, you know that Jamie Dimon was like, I will fire any trader or anybody who's under my employment who deals in Bitcoin or sells and trades Bitcoin. Meanwhile, they were mining it. I think they were secretly buying it too. So, here we are. And JP Morgan, this was like a month ago, they said, Bitcoin will never go above 40,000 again. Just can't really sustain it, right? Experts are funny because experts can only tell you what was. They can't tell you what will be. So when we look at these financial experts in the traditional markets, sure, it makes sense, right? But that's the traditional markets. And again, it's a little bit different. So just remember when you're seeing all these naysayers and they say, it's not going to happen, not going to happen. Look at some of the past things that they've said and look at how many times Bitcoin and cryptocurrency digital assets have died. And here we are. So just a little reminder, that's all.